me and talk to me. What's wrong with me? But we all got these issues. Issues, and sin has got us bound down, and nobody want to be around us. Nobody want to be around us. So we bent over, and we can't hardly walk. We can't talk, and we can't see. And be honest with you, we need somebody to lead us and guide us, but they can't do that because we are unclean. And if you go in the book of Leviticus, it'll even tell you that the garments will be unclean. And it also go and describe how that you could, how they could check it by the fire and by the water. And you can see whether it's unclean or not. And it will tell you sometime to keep it or you can burn it.
But what about us
when people scandalize our name? Put our name on the signing board. And we left out in the dark.
Thank you, Lord.
And we have no one to turn to.
Amen.
Those are some lonely nights and some lonely days. We have no one to turn to, and all of a sudden we hear about a revival is going on. We hear that Jesus just might be coming through town.
Yes, sir.
We hear that there's somebody that can only, all they have to do is speak the word, and the blind will receive the sight. The lame that couldn't walk will get up and walk. All of a sudden, we hear about a man named Jesus. That at that name, the demons begin to tremble. But at that name, that you every knee is going to have to bow.
Come on.
My Lord.
We hear about Jesus. It's coming by. Because we can't get no close to him, we holler out, Lord, have mercy. I got to explain to you what mercy is. Mercy is not getting what you do deserve.
Yes, sir.
Go on now.
There are some things that you do deserve.
But God.
There are some things that we all do deserve.
Yes, sir.
But God. God allowed us to come here today, but there's some things that we've done in our life. Even right now, we deserve some things. We deserve some punishment. But God,
come on,
just a little mercy on us. Let me tell you about grace then. Since you want to hear about grace. Grace is getting what you do not deserve. Every now and then, if you think about it, if you have a home...
Now, you go ahead, I'll put it together.
They have a 30-day grace period or a 10-day grace period.
Yes, sir.
And if you don't pay your bill, you got 10 days to stench.
Yes.
You don't deserve it, but you get it anyway. I'm talking about grace this morning.
Yes, sir.
I'm talking about God having mercy on us this morning.
Yes, sir.
But when they cried out, they said, Lord, have mercy on us.
Yes, sir.
All right, then. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Look like I see somebody coming through the door.
Yes.
Look like my daddy.
Yes.
I'm feeling all right now.
That's all right.
I got some help coming.
Amen. It's all right now.
Look like my daddy.
Amen.
I don't know how old he is, but grace and mercy. Has followed him a mighty long time.
Yes,
David said, have mercy on me.
That's
all right.
Yes.
I gotta slow down now because I'm feeling happy.
Yes. All right.
Down on the inside.
Yes. That's all right.
But Jesus said, they said, Lord, have mercy on us.
Yes.
Sometimes the things get bad to you, bro.
My Lord.
You're going to ask God to have mercy on you.
Yes.
Yes,
sir.
And so you got to get to the point where you know you got to need God.
Yes, sir.
As long as you're up, as long as you're able to do for yourself and get around,
that's right.
You feel like you don't need God.
Yes.
But just as soon as you get down on your back, you start talking to God.
Yes.
God is a toy or something.
Yeah.
And then you get in trouble.
Yeah.
The first thing we holler is, Lord, have mercy.
Yes, Lord.
And God is good.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
To have mercy.
Yes, sir.
Yes, good. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Jesus said, go. Show thyself to the priest.
Yeah.
The reason why he said that, there's a law.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
That any time a miracle is performed,
yeah,
that the person that was unclean would have to go to the priest.
Yeah.
And then he would have to declare it to be a miracle.
Yeah.
Now, if that would have been us, asking God to have mercy on us.
Uh-huh.
And he told us to go to the church house.
Uh-huh.
Matter of fact, let's go down to the River of Jordan.
Uh-huh.
If he asks us to dip seven times in the water.
Yeah.
Why didn't you come out and talk to me yourself?
Come on.
I'm going to slow that down too.
Go
I'm going somewhere else with them.
Come on.
But anyway. He said, go show thyself to the priest.
Uh-huh.
The Bible said, as it came to pass,
uh-huh,
they were all clean.
Yeah. Thank you, God.
So I looked at my hand.
Uh-huh.
And they looked new.
Yeah.
So I looked at my feet.
Yeah.
And they did too.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What a good God that we serve.
Yeah.
Anytime that your hands is wrinkled all up,
yeah,
got the gout,
yeah,
can't straighten the legs out, can't stand up on your own two feet,
yes,
and God have mercy. And the only thing he said was go,
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 and your hands
begin
to clear up.
Look,
what was once white,
yeah,
began to have a little color,
yeah,
yeah,
what I couldn't see, I was able to see it then. The skin that was falling off my body.
Yeah.
Somehow he asked Ezekiel, can these fall off?
Oh.
And Ezekiel said, Lord, that you know. I feel pretty good.
That's all right, man.
Lord, you know.
Yeah, you know. Yes, sir.
Hello.
Come on.
Can these bones live?
Yeah.
But what I like about it, if I can get one person in here today,
yeah,
I know you think we're in a bad situation. I know you think we're in trouble.
Yeah.
I know people talking about it.
Come on.
I know people don't mind on it. But if I can get one person to make a turn,
yeah,
give God some praise.
Glory. Glory!
Turn the whole situation around. If I can do one.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Come on, man. Right now.
Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Got 10 chairs in the night.
Yes,
hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Excuse me, brother.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Lord. It has 10 chairs in the night.
Look.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
When I look around, everybody's gone.
Yeah. Not right now.
Only one is standing.
Yeah!
Come on,
man. Come on,
now look around.
All right, Richard.
Out in the pulpit.
Yeah!
Where the church used to be full.
Yeah!
What happened to the night?
Yeah!
That's what I'm trying to get to.
Yeah!
Come on, man.
You mean to tell me it was only one that was so thankful?
Yeah!
They didn't mind turning back
yeah.
and giving God some praise.
Yeah.
with every tongue to give glory to God, save this stranger, which is a Samaritan. Somebody has been cast out, cast aside, cast down, considered dogs at one time. But because of the blood of Jesus, you were drafted into the family of Jesus Christ. Because of his grace and his mercy, we are all drafted into the body of Christ. And it's nothing good that we've done. But God just had a little mercy and a little grace on us. That's all he did. That's all he did. Mercy and grace. And if we would take this to mind and consider some things that we have been through, we have gone through. Matter of fact, I'm speaking this now, some things that we are getting ready to go through.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah.
God will have mercy.
Yes, he will.
And he'll have grace.
Yes, he will. Yes, sir. Thank you, God. Yes, he will. Yes, sir.
And I believe at this point right now, 2 Luke number 2.
All right.
God is getting ready to do some great things.
Yes, sir.
He's going to do some great things. Because I do believe that we got one or two that don't mind giving God some honor, giving him some praise, and giving him some glory.
Yes,
I believe that in my heart.
Yes,
and when we do that, the Bible says, if he be lifted up, he'll draw all men unto him.
Yes,
we're going to lift him up. Let people say what they want to say, what they want to do.
Yes.
We're going to lift God up.
Yes.
We're going to give God the praise.
Yes.
And we're going to watch God do some things in this church. It may look seem bad. It may look bad. But God knows he worked everything out.
Yes, he did.